Yesterday I mentioned that it's a battle for our minds, so today I want to discuss who the battle for our minds is between. Is it a battle between our Creator and the adversary, the same one that He cast down here and has been allowed to have the influence over us? Before we get into who the battle is between, since Satan is an obvious player in the battle, let's discuss what Isaiah prophesied that he would purpose, which is to change our Creator's appointed times and His laws. In Isaiah chapter 14 we read, "For thou hast set in thine heart, I will ascend into heaven. I will exalt my throne above the stars of Elohim. I will sit also upon the mount of the appointed times in the sides of the north. I will ascend above the heights of the clouds, and I will be like the Most High." Many of you know nothing about the appointed times that El Shaddai gave us to live by and to observe. I will briefly explain. It's kind of like having a doctor's appointment. The doctor wants to heal you, but you have to show up for the appointment. Then you have to listen to his advice that he gives you while you're at the appointment in order to be healed. This is how our Creator drew it up when he put man here. We read in Genesis 1, "And Elohim said, Let there be lights in the firmament of the heavens to divide the day from the night, and let them be for signs and for his appointed times and for days and years." So we see plainly that he put the sun and the moon in place so we could keep track of his appointed times. The weekly and the annual Sabbaths are his appointed times. This is important because we must determine why was Satan placed here and why has he a purpose to change the times and the laws. Did our Creator know that this is what Satan would purpose to do? Of course he did. So he was allowed to do this, but why? Satan could not change the appointed times because they are written in the Word of Yahweh, which will endure forever. So how could he steal the worship? The only way that would be for him to change the calendar that people use. So those who wanted to obey their Creator and show up for the doctor's appointments would show up at the wrong time and the doctor would not be there. Guess what? This is also recorded that would happen. In Daniel 7, "And he shall speak great words against the Most High and shall wear out the saints of the Most High and think to change the times and the laws. And they shall be given into his hand," this is important to catch this, "until a time, times, and a dividing of time." Yes, Satan has changed the laws indeed. He has done away with them, and he has successfully deceived the world. But how is this possible? Is Satan more powerful than his Creator? Of course not. Satan is a pawn. His rebellion against his Maker is actually helping his Creator to accomplish his purpose to build a family. And Satan has not understood this. He thinks that he has stolen the worship and is laughing all the way to the bank. Oops, he forgets the end of the story. He will be brought down. But why did our Creator give us over to his hands in the first place? Why was he allowed to sift us? Why was he allowed to influence our minds? This too is recorded. As I say so often, it is merely a matter of believing and living by every word, just as Yeshua did and commanded and instructed us to do. In Isaiah 59, we read, "Behold, Yahweh's hand is not shortened that it cannot save, neither is his ear heavy that it cannot hear. But your iniquities have separated between you and your Elohim. Your sins have hid his face from you that he will not hear. For your hands are defiled with blood and your fingers with iniquity. Your lips have spoken lies. Your tongue hath muttered perversions. None calleth for justice." Everybody just wants to turn their cheek to all the blasphemies done in his name even. Nor pleadeth for truth. People don't want the truth. They trust in vanity. They trust in their own ways. They speak lies, the lies they've been taught. They conceive mischief and bring forth iniquity or lawlessness. So we see here that he can hear just fine. It is because of our choice to believe lies, our choices to not hearken unto his instructions like Adam and Eve did. And everyone's done since then. And therefore, he turns us over to Satan, as we read back there. It is because we confess to know him and we confess that the blood of his son has cleansed us, but we continue to choose to live lies. Our actions defile the blood of his son. There are thousands and thousands of religious teachers out there that they mean well, but they're teaching, they're Satan's ambassadors. And they choose to believe the lies instead of believing the very words that they teach from. They teach the very perversions of the truth that were put in place by their father, Satan. Yahweh wants us to become his, but would you want rebellious children in your family? He sent his son to die on our behalf to show us how much he loves us. And what has man done? They have turned his grace and his mercy into a license to transgress his statutes. These are the same statutes that he put in place forever to teach us how to have perfect character, his character, and teach us to love like with his type of love. So is it a battle between him and Satan? Absolutely not. He can exterminate Satan in less than a nanosecond at any time he chooses. The battle for our minds was designed to be a battle between us and Satan. This is why our Creator gave us free will and free agency to choose to want him. The only way that we can be victorious is with his help, but it is our iniquities that keep him from giving us that help. It is our choice to not believe him and to act on that belief. Our Creator placed an adversary here that we cannot overcome on our own to show us that our thoughts are useless if they're not in agreement with him. We need his help. He offers to protect us from this adversary if we will hearken unto his instructions. If not, he tells us that he will simply turn us over to Satan's system, who also thought he knew a better way. He turns us over to our own will to live out our lives apart from him, choosing right and wrong for ourselves as a witness against us when we are brought before the judgment seat. And everyone will be brought before the judgment seat. So this is certainly not a battle between our Creator and Satan. It is a battle for our minds, but that is an internal battle of whether we will surrender to the will of our Creator and let him fashion us into his image, the image that his Son embraced and taught us to embrace, the way that leads to life, or will we hold on to our thoughts and reject his instructions? The battle is between our choice to surrender all to him or to choose to live what we think is right in our own eyes. Man has rolled over and chosen to walk in the dark by choosing right or wrong for themselves, making their God from the programming that they have chosen to receive from the father of lies because they would not believe the truth. In doing so, they have made Satan their father or their God. El Shaddai gave us free will to overcome self and to want him, and he gave us the instructions on how he would engage and fight all other battles on our behalf, which includes protecting us from the deceptive powers that he allows Satan to have for a season and for a reason. Because man has rejected their Creator's protection, Satan has been allowed to set up a domain and receive worship for himself. He accomplished this by erasing the laws from the minds of those who follow him and by changing the calendar system that man uses so that they are not showing up to the doctor when the doctor is there and so that they can be healed. We must remember that he would not have had the power to deceive in the first place if we did not reject the truth and choose to live lies over the words that our Creator gave us. This will be a witness against man to humble him when he is resurrected to find out that he had chosen to worship Satan by worshiping his system and instead of believing his Creator. All knees will bow. In Isaiah 45, we read, "Look unto me and be ye saved, all the ends of the earth, for I am Elohim and there is none else. I have sworn by myself, the word is gone out from my mouth is righteousness and shall not return that until every knee shall bow and every tongue shall swear." Satan has deceived man because man refused the protection by refusing the protector's instructions. This is why the soon coming destruction will be mighty. The wrath of our Creator is about to be ready to be released because man has rejected him. My father has nearly accomplished his purpose to build on the first fruits of his family in the 6,000 years that was allotted to man. And the final refining is almost complete, and the first trumpet blast will sound soon. He has called many out of the darkness to be a part of this number, but few have chosen him. Many came partially to the call, only to get stuck into the false teachings of deceived men who follow their father, Satan. They fell because they would not believe and live by every word that their Creator gave. Somewhere in the process, they chose to decide right and wrong for themselves instead of believing their Maker. Although the completion of the first fruits into his family is at hand, my father has a second harvest planned, and that will be harvested after a 1,000-year reign of his Son and of the first fruits. He is now calling forth the people to live into a new age of time where his Son will rule and to be a part of that second harvest. I suggest that you flee from the lies as these 144,000 who have gone before you have done, and hearken unto the instructions that he has given to us and fight to be a part of what he has to offer, eternal life in his family. Repent and choose the light. Satan is on the prowl with a vengeance for these last 500 plus days because he knows that he has but a very short time. He also knows that he will be let loose for a little season after 1,000 years, so prepare your minds against that point. Solidify it in your mind that no matter what happens, you will choose to live by every word that your Elohim gave you to walk in, because you want him. You want what he has to offer. Whether it means giving up your life or what have you, stand for what he has spoken and live it. Choose to let your Creator and his Son and all of the legions of angels that they will dispatch on your behalf take on the battle on your behalf, because I can assure you, if Elohim and his Son are living in you, greater is he that who is in you than he that is in the world. The only way that they are going to take up residence in you is if you repent from living the lies and stop taking Yeshua's shed blood in vain. Allow that blood to wash and clean you, and allow them to teach you the truth. We have about reached the time when Yahweh Elohim is going to show the world that it is not a battle between him and Satan, as Satan thinks. It is about him giving man 6,000 years to choose to overcome all obstacles and to become part of his family, and to choose to make sure that they were on his side, being called by his name, representing his character, so that he would have gathered us under his wings to protect us from the deceiver. Each of us needs to reach a point of humility that we realize that we are nothing apart from him, and fight to be in agreement with him so that he will fight on our behalf. This is, of course, like I said, nothing can withstand him. He is almighty, all powerful. This is what repentance is. It is change. And the blood of his Son will cleanse us from all of our past unrighteousness. We must fight to be perfect as he is perfect, which means that we are to take on our Creator's character, his moral character. This is a commandment from the one who died on your behalf. Stop taking his blood in vain, defiling it by living like you have a license to transgress his father's laws that were put here in place to bring you into his truth anyway.